Välkomna till ännu ett avsnitt av Veteranbils TV. Mitt namn är Bernt Ståhl och idag så har vi faktiskt hamnat i ett garage. Men det är inte vilket garage som helst har vi inte hamnat i, utan... May I ask, where are we today?
Today we are in the east of Pretoria, yes. At the WSJ garage.
And where is that located? Which country?
In South Africa, obviously.
Yes, in South Africa.
Yes.
So, vi är tillbaka i Sydafrika med ännu ett program härifrån. Men nu har vi hittat någonting som är helt otroligt alltså. Det är alltså ett garage som är fullt av bilar som är till salu, eller de har bara ställt in dem här över vintern eller över sommaren, så kanske det är egentligen då. Men vi har hittat en bil här nu som jag vill titta lite närmare på. So, I will just explain a little bit in Swedish. What kind of car is this?
This is a 1969 Valiant Barracuda.
Valiant,
you probably know
Valiant,
it as the Plymouth. Valiant,
Valiant,
yeah. Barracuda.
That is important, you know, that it's a Valiant. So there's a difference. So det är en skillnad mellan den här som vi brukar ha i Sverige, den här, och det är en Barracuda. Men is it really a Barracuda?
It is,
yes,
really
it is.
A Barracuda.
It is really a Barracuda. But this car, was it produced in the States or in South Africa?
This car was produced in South Africa.
Yeah, so this is literally, there was came in like a knockdown that in that
that sense. Is correct, yes. It's a semi, yeah. Knockdown and assembled and finished in South Africa.
Yeah, do you know where it was in South Africa?
I am not 100% sure. Yeah. We can check the tags on it, but it might be PE or somewhere of those areas.
What do you mean PE?
Port Elizabeth.
Okay, so it's down in the eastern part.
In the coast, yes. Yeah. Yes.
But this is really a Barracuda, it says, and you have all the lines here. Everything is beautiful. And
thank
you. Also got the... The cap here for the fuel,
the right it should cap, be, yes, as it should be. The only thing missing on the vehicle is the hubcaps.
The hubcaps,
that
okay.
Is, we went that way for a specific look on the car.
Yeah, because it looks like a racing.
Exactly, yeah. a little bit more mean on that side, yes.
But it's easy to restore back to the previous glories if you want, you know. But this one looks nice, you know.
Yes.
But the funny thing is, I see there's something wrong with this car. Oh, maybe the door is not open.
Let me go and open the door from that side.
Yeah. Because there's something wrong with this one. Because
normally, I know where you're going with this.
Yes, you know. But the thing is, there should be a steering wheel here. There should be a steering wheel.
I knew you were going that way. I knew you were going that way.
Me too.
So that's part of the reason that it's the Valiant Barracuda, South African version, right-hand drive, obviously, as well.
So the thing is, let's look a little bit on the interior. So then we go from the correct side of the car.
There we go.
Then it's the interior, and as you said, you have moved the steering wheel here to the correct side, but there seems to be...
I'm glad you call it the correct side.
I've learned. I learned from the British. So, I mean, the steering wheel is obviously a repro thing.
Yes, yes, it is.
But
it
the dash is literally like it, but it's turned around.
It's all factory. That's the thing with these older cars. It was all so symmetrical that to make it a left to right hand or right to left hand is very simple. It can just interchange everything. Yes.
Yeah. I mean, you have this one here because okay. No, all the seat seems to be original also.
Yeah, we tried to when we rebuilt the car, we tried to keep the interior original. This is the original seats from factory, including the dash and the cluster.
So you have rebuilt the car here.
We did rebuild the car. Yes. Yes.
Okay.
So it's been restored. Unfortunately, it was restored for a client in Australia.
Okay.
Since they also do right-hand drives that side, so the car will be headed to Australia very shortly.
Yeah, okay.
Unfortunately.
Yeah. Unfortunate for you, but for the country here, but not for your pocket. Not for your pocket.
The pocket does okay. The pocket does okay.
Yeah. But then it's like interesting on this car. What kind of engine do we have in this one?
What would you say?
Yeah, what I would say, because I mean, you gave me like a hint here on the Valiant thing, you know.
Yeah.
You did like that, so I'm a little bit worried on this one. What it is, literally, you know.
Can I open it up for you?
Yeah, you can open it up.
Let me open it up for you.
Yeah. So let's open up and see what we got inside here.
Let's have a look.
Yes. Yes. Please. Open. Open it up. Yes, it's not what I thought.
Why not?
Because I mean, but you gave me a hint with the Valiant.
Because
this is not a V8 in this.
It's not in a V, and there's not eight cylinders. There's only six of them, and it's all in a straight line.
Yes,
all in a straight line.
And this is because of it's South African made.
That is because of South African made. Yeah. So abroad and everywhere else, they were the Plymouths, and they had the big 383 V8s.
So this is meaning that when you see Valiant down here, straight six.
Some people say straight six. If you have a look at the engine, it's also called a slant six.
Slant, yeah.
So it's slanted to one side. The engine's almost sitting at an angle. But yes, that's also original for the South African Valiant, as you can see on the VIN tags as well.
You said it was maybe Port Elizabeth.
South African. It's not Port Elizabeth. I made a mistake there. It was assembled by Chrysler South Africa in Elsies River in Cape Town.
Okay, so it came from Cape Town. Man, this was not what we expected, you know.
No, definitely not. A lot of people, when they look at this car with the lines and the muscle effect that it shows, they don't expect a normal old six-cylinder engine
What cubic inches is in this one?
This would be, again, I would need to double-check for you, but it would be, as far as I gather, it would be a 4.1 litre.
Then we know what it is anyhow. So, you know, the horsepower on this one is around 200?
Around there, maybe a little bit less.
Yeah, 185.
It's a car that looks like it's built for a lot of power, but with this engine in there, it's not the most of the beast car. That's why a lot of people do the conversion from the straight six to the V8 engine, the 383 cubic inch.
But this is the original one. But this one, as I've heard, it's sold.
This one is unfortunately sold. Yes.
And where do you in this country, or is going to go some abroad, or what is it?
We are usually not in the market to export cars to other countries. We prefer keeping them in South Africa. But unfortunately, this car, the bio, he had something similar when he was younger, and he is in Australia, so he wanted the vehicle.
Yeah, because then you don't have to convert or anything like that.
Exactly, already right-hand drive and all that. It might just get a V8 engine when it gets that side, but you don't know. You don't know.
It's not your problem.
That's not my problem.
But it's not original anymore.
That's the thing. We prefer dealing in original classics.
Now this is really, you know, really really sharp car, you know.
Thank you, sir.
Like the surprise on this one. But you gave me a hint when you said Valiant.
As you saw on the steering wheel, that's an aftermarket steering wheel, and on that it shows Plymouth.
Yes, it does. It does, in fact, yes. I was trying not to avoid that one, you know.
I see.
Very, very nice. But, you know, is it possible that you and I can take a small ride with this one?
Absolutely. That's not a problem. It is South Africa, but we do still have petrol, so you are welcome. Let's go for a spin.
So then we can not stand with the hood open, you know. Then you need to close down the hood.
Yes, I need to close the hood, and then we just hop in. Please make sure you hop in on the right side of the car, not the driver's side.
Because I think for insurance thing, it's better that...
It would be better that way. Yeah. But we can still go for a lekker drive.
Yeah, it sounds. What have you done?
The exhaust.
The exhaust. You're cheating a little bit.
A little bit. It needs to have the sound. Okay, let's go for a drive.
So in fact, you said you did do the renovation on this car.
That's correct. Yes.
Yeah. They exist quite a lot of these ones down here still, or?
There's a couple, not all too easy to find. The people have been exporting them like crazy, but yes, you can still find one or two around here.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Right. But how long was the renovation of this one?
It was not too bad. We did it in about 8 months.
8 months?
Yeah.
That's quite quick, I must say.
Yeah, well, we were fortunate that we could keep the interior unchanged, the original. Okay. We didn't have to do the interior.
So
it was basically bodywork, paint, and engine, and then obviously the brakes and drivetrain Unfortunately, it was rusted all the way through.
Yeah, from there, because you have the salt.
This car, we bought it from a guy in Port Elizabeth.
Yeah.
And he had it. The previous owner, the car actually has quite a good story. The previous owner, one of the previous owners, was a prominent boxing... boxing champion of South Africa. So luckily we managed to get our hands on the car before it rusted away completely.
So it's been standing there for many years.
And he always had plans to fix it up and restore
better. They always say
that. But how it goes. It just never gets to be done.
No.
Yeah.
No, they're always like that, you know. But you don't really import anything from USA here in South Africa?
There's a lot. There's a lot of imports happening and cars entering the country, luckily, especially the past couple of years.
Yeah.
I think South African prices have sort of started to be in line with international figures.
Okay.
And that's why people can now import vehicles as well. And then... now you got traffic.
Yeah, but you can turn around if you want.
Yeah, I'm just gonna go.
Yeah, you go around that left corner. Yeah, that's good. Just left it there.
There's a lot of bumps.
Yeah. At least we have. Oh.
That's the other pleasure and benefit of driving a classic car. Everybody gives you right of way.
Yeah, I was wondering, you know, because normally they will push you. Yeah, it is true. And everybody's smiling also.
Everybody's smiling.
Yes.
The cops pull you over. It's not to give you a ticket. It's because they want to look
true.
At the car.
It is true. That happened to me also. It has happened to me also.
Thank you.
It is totally true. Yeah.
Done with speed bumps for a while.
Yes.
Morgen, morgen. Ek snap julle interview. Ek kom. There we go.
Yes. So just stop here in front.
Stop outside?
Yes, stop outside, and then we just, then you can, no, thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you for your time.
For this one, and it was really pressure with this car, you know, really pressure for this one, you know.
I appreciate that, okay. Thank you very thank much.
Och jag är fortfarande faktiskt nere i Sydafrika i ett litet garage. Och när jag trodde allting var över så hittade jag den här bilen. Och vad är det här? Jo, det här är en, ja, ni ser ju, en Ute. Det är alltså en Holden Ute, men nej, det råkar inte heta det nu. Om ni tittar här på sidan så ser ni att det står, utan någon konstig anledning, El Camino. Men så här ser de andra ut i USA. Utan det här är alltså en Holden från ungefär på 70-talet. Och det är en sån här bil som, ja, jag trodde jag aldrig skulle få se den. Jag som är en Holden-ägare och allting. Ja. Och så, herregud. Så här ser den ut inuti. Ja, automatlåda, V8, hela köret är det. Kära min vän. Och några ser ut i motor. Så här ser den ut inuti. Det är helt otroligt alltså. Ja. Ja. Ibland har man tur, eller hur? Ja. Och det är alltså, bucky är det ju det här. Chevrolet, ja. Helt otroligt, grabbar. Jo, han är faktiskt öppen motorhuven. Ja, då öppnar vi upp här då. Och här har vi motorn. Ja. V8, hela köret. Oj, 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 oj. Ja. Det är precis. Det hade man inte räknat med. Hade man inte räknat med det här, det kan jag säga. Herregud, ja. Så, tack så mycket för den här gången. Det var en liten extra grej ni fick med er här. Från Australien och Sydafrika. En blandning mellan allt.